truth is a fact, a fib is a fiction. A theory is a clear and objective description of that which exists, how it is, how it isn't, by history or science or some defined discipline. And so theory goes. If you hold the opinion that truth is so easily known and envisioned. But what if, quote, truth as you know it is hidden by myths you've been told that you don't know you're living? What if powers that be control how the truth's given, and even how science and history are written, and even the means of theorizing's conditioned by the interest of those in the power position? Well, in that case, our theories would need criticism, and this is called critical theory. Its mission to sift out the shit and call out the system. What system is it? It's capitalism. It started with a question within Marxism. Is the revolution working? Oh, darn, it isn't. Well, the Bolsheviks revolted, the autocrats co-opted it, but the problem's not communists, the problem is consciousness. All we can think is what we have known, and all we've ever known is that things can be owned, and to bite, scratch, and claw to get your possessions, and life is a bitch if dog eat dog's your first premise. It's get what you get since the get-go, it's endless, the notion's so close we don't notice its presence. Every system we inscribe's reinstated its essence in hieroglyphs, Bibles, and declarations of independence. All of our relations, a human and their nation, a human and another human, a human and mother nature, are reduced to an equation of consumeristic labor. You know what I'm saying? You get what you pay for. So critical theory looks at our history, all of its books and ambiguous victories, all of its answers and questions them critically. Why everyone says they want freedom but isn't free? And so what began in the context of economics became a critique of a complex of concepts that constitute the basis of the ideological constructs that course through our culture and complicate all of it. And it's the predecessor of identity politics and feminist call-outs of patriarchal nonsense and critiques of white privilege and fights for racial justice that say what's left unsaid and just how unjust it is. And make you wake up to what's real till you're woke to the wheel of control in which you're a mere spoke. For the system's not broken, it breaks you, you're broke. And it ain't funny, bro, your truth is a joke. But then here's a problem. If all I've been told is a product of forces and forms of control that inform all I do when I'm thinking of stuff, well then how I know who to be critical of? Take a pair of sources of important information, like a couple of our never-ending news organizations, making two new contradictory yet very forceful statements. Who's to say which of the two you should believe and who to take a spin? You maybe move to say whichever's based upon the evidence, but if you had the evidence, you'd only then make sense of it directly through the prism of whatever your perspective is. Perspective that's affected by whatever else is said to it. But if it's all relative, then how is there a hell to give? Even that it's relative itself is kind of relative, whether you're a liberal with conservative relatives or a rebel who would kill to live well in the hell you live. And this is relevant, since critical questioning gets weaponized by your side and your enemies, characterizing this 21st century in endless critique with increasing intensity. And so a theory that's designed to find and call out all the liars now is also called upon by those designing to divide us. It's the tool that's used to fight the privileged class and bank insiders, but it's also used to justify the climate change deniers. It's the basis of all of the words in these raps, but also fake news and alternative facts. Even maniacs and bigots try to speak their truth to power, each is saying louder that their truth is ours.